TheDailyMass.com. Experience the Roman Catholic Mass from historic St. Louis Cathedral every day on TheDailyMass.com. His love, anywhere in the world.
I'm Sarah McDonald.
And I'm Jason Angelette. Welcome to Issues in Faith.
Well, we have finished, we've concluded our carnival season, and we are in the holy season of Lent.
That's right. Just a beautiful time for prayer, fasting, but I guess to kind of go more into like a one-on-one, a 101 rather, of this time right now. What does this time represent, and what does it mean?
Lent is, time for us to encourage our spiritual growth. Mm-hmm. It's our time. You use one-on-one. I thought you were going to go improve our one-on-one relationship
yeah,
with
exactly.
God.
Yeah, exactly.
So I thought you were going there, but it's the
God.
Perfect thing to say.
Yeah.
It's our time to take personal reflection and strengthen our spiritual lives so that we can strengthen our relationship with God. And it's all in preparation for Easter. And Archbishop Amen is calling on us to do a little bit extra this Lent. And we're going to do the one-on-one. But Archbishop Amen sent a letter out that was read at all Masses yesterday and will be made available this weekend to people in the pews, as we went from, asking people to add another day of prayer and abstinence and fasting for the violence that's in our city. And just another, he's asking, encouraging that so that we can sort of try to purge our city of this violence that's just completely out of control. It's sad when you watch the news or read the paper in the morning. So the Archbishop is committed to his new Battle of New Orleans, and he's asking us to join him in prayer, fasting, and
praise
abstinence.
God.
But and we're going to talk about what fasting and abstinence actually mean and why we do it. But first, everyone was walking around, Catholics, mm-hmm. and even some non-Catholics, yesterday were walking around with ashes on their forehead, an ash mm-hmm. cross. What do those ashes mean?
Well, the ashes go back in the Old Testament. We see that in many situations, whether it was in the book of Job, in the book of Daniel, basically in Esther too. But it talked about, Daniel said, I turned to the Lord God, pleading in earnest prayer with fasting, sackcloth, and ashes. So it's this symbolizing this mourning, this moment of penance, and this mourning that realizing that our mortality of who we are before the Lord.
And that's so important, especially in America today. We get so caught up in the world, revolving around the you and revolving around us. And so it's a time for us to step back from that. And in doing so, we are asked to fast and abstain. And just for our viewers, you can see Jason and I are going high tech today with our iPads. But fasting refers to the restrictions on the quantity of food we eat, and abstaining refers to giving up a certain type of food.
That's right.
And so fasting, the liturgical norm for fasting means, and the days of fasting are Ash Wednesday, Good Friday, and all Fridays of Lent, and that fasting means you may have two very small meals, and it cannot add up to your one large meal of the day, no eating in between.
Right.
And abstaining, the church asks us to abstain from meat. And people will ask, well, why do we do this? What's the deal? And in the Acts of the Apostles, Peter saw a vision and said, all food, Christians can eat all food, which is different from what was told to our Jewish brothers and sisters in the Old Testament.
Right.
But when we abstain, we're giving up something good.
And so
it's for our spiritual well-being. We are voluntarily giving up something good for our spiritual well-being, and that's what we do with both fasting and abstinence.
And these 40 days start Ash Wednesday, and they go through, but they exclude Sundays, is that correct?
They do exclude Sundays, and because you can't call fasting and abstinence on the Lord's Day.
That's
the church rule. But Lent actually ends before the Holy Thursday Mass. Service is on Holy Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
However, the Lenten practice
extends to the vigil of Easter.
That's right. And so that's what a lot of people get confused about. When does Lent actually end? Am I free from my Lenten obligations? No, you're to hold that. The church started this practice in Reform to give precedence to those three holy days, the Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and Holy Saturday in preparation for
So the 40 days mimic, the imitate rather, the life of Jesus, him giving going into the fasting, into the desert, into the wilderness for those 40 days, along with all the wonderful Old Testament prophets fasting and praying for 40 days different times throughout the year, or throughout the different moments in throughout the history. But also, too, that these 40 days do not include Sunday, that they're like mini Easters, so that we don't fast there. And then on Fridays throughout Lent, abstaining from all meat. And then on Ash Wednesday and Good Friday, abstaining from meat along with fasting, which is one small meal and then a regular meal and then two snacks that don't equal another meal.
Right. And just for the record, we're running out of time. Our director is talking to us in our ear. But for the record, the Catholic Church does not require mm-hmm. that Catholics not eat meat on Fridays throughout the year, but it's recommended.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't understand that.
That's
it's
right.
recommended not
outside.
To eat meat
right.
outside of the Lenten season. But if you do eat meat during Friday on a Friday outside of Lent, the church asks you to do some other sort of
that's
penance.
Actually really, that's
so
right.
That's a little tidbit for our viewers. Well, to help us in this area with our Lenten penance and our Lenten reflection, the Catholic Women in Action Committee has planned several events specifically targeted at our Lenten penance and building our relationships with God. And Jason's going to sit down with Sharon Rohde and Roy-Anne Avegno to talk more about those upcoming activities.
Well, thank you so much to be with us, Roy-Anne Avegno. Thank you very much, Sharon Rohde. Good
me.
To have
Hi,
you
Jason.
Again with us.
Nice to see you.
So tell us, I guess first we're going to go with you. Tell us about this event that's coming up and also the group that brings this event together.
Well, last year, this Catholic Women in Action is a program of the Catholic Foundation of the Archdiocese of New Orleans. And last year, Barbara Windhorst came up with this idea. And the purpose of our group is to encourage women in their spiritual growth, to encourage women to live out their faith and values in service to others, and to also grow in their stewardship and support of the ministries of the Archdiocese of New Orleans through the Catholic Foundation. So, taking that all together, the first thing that we did was to set up a Lenten series, and it was a woman's spiritual legacy, or a woman's spiritual journey is what we called it. And we had three speakers on three different weekdays in Lent, and they talked about their spiritual journey and what their faith means to them. And we also did two sessions in Advent, and we're going to do three more sessions this Lent. All of them are at St. Francis Xavier Church on Metairie Road. They begin with 8 o'clock Mass, and after Mass, our celebrant speaks, and then the three people speak. And it's over by about 10:30, but last year we had over 300 people wow. attend, and it was really wonderful. It's a good beginning of Lent. It's a good way to keep your Lenten hopes go alive, and it was very successful, and we're hoping for the same this year.
We have very various speakers coming in, and Roy-Anne, you're one of them. And so tell us a little bit about what your messages you plan to bring to the group.
Well, the theme for this series, in keeping with Archbishop Amon's theme, is the Eucharist.
That's right.
And how we can deepen our love for the Eucharist.
Amen.
So that it will be something that I'll talk about, how being a Catholic has influenced my life. And of course, at the heart of Catholicism is the Eucharist, and
yes.
how that has helped me and strengthened me and nourished me throughout my life.
Amen. What a powerful message. I mean, you can't get anything more than the source and summit of the Christian life, and to encourage that growth in that, in receiving Christ and being present before Him.
Absolutely.
So, what has it been for you on this journey of life, bringing Christ more centered into your life?
As I was reflecting on what I might say, I thought about the first memory that I have of school.
Mm-hmm.
And I realized that my very first school memory was not a memory of the classroom. It was a memory of the church.
Really?
And I would go to the church at recess. I just felt drawn to go into church at recess.
Wow.
I was a little bit afraid, though, because I was small and the church looked so enormous to
yes.
me. And I was afraid that the door might close and I'd be locked in. So I would have my friends stand by the door for a little
true.
while I was in church. But when I realized that, I understood that as far back as I can remember, I have felt the need and the desire to have God present in the most intimate possible way, that's the Eucharist.
What has this Women in Action, these series, what kind of fruit have you seen bear from it?
Well, we've seen women very much encouraged and bringing forth to do more for the church and become more involved. We were amazed at the number of people that came last year, and they came once and they came back a second time and a third time. And we're hoping for the same this year. Last year we had them on Wednesdays. Some people couldn't make Wednesdays, so this year we're doing Tuesday to give those that weren't able to come on Wednesdays the opportunity.
Again, what are the dates?
The dates are February 28th, March 6th, and March 13th at St. Francis Xavier Church. Father Taramina has been so cooperative and helpful. And it begins with 8 o'clock Mass. If you can't make the 8 o'clock Mass, which of course we hope everyone can, the talks begin about 10 minutes to 9, and everything is over by 10:30.
Such a great way to inspire the faith, especially during the Lenten season.
Right.
And who's the person to contact for this?
The person to contact is Manette Wolf at the Catholic Foundation, and her number is 310-6981. 310-6981. And there are also confessions that are available.
Fantastic.
We have two priests who are there at the end of our talks.
Well, thank you all so much for being with us. God bless you in all that you do. Thanks so much.
Thank you again.
For more information, you can contact Manette Wolf at 310-6981. This is Issues in Faith. We'll be right back.
The science of learning is an imperfect one, but Louisiana Catholic schools have consistently instituted a formula for success. An astonishing 95% of Catholic school students go on to college. And last year, they brought with them over $185 million in scholarship awards. Shouldn't you invest in success and the confident leaders of tomorrow? Louisiana Catholic Schools, in a class of their own.
Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the message by the signs that attended it.
Welcome back to Issues in Faith. Well, you just saw a clip from the Truth and Life Bible. And on the phone, I have the creator of this project, Mr. Mike Stark. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you, Sarah. I'd love to tell the story.
Well, and that's why we're here tonight, because you made it your mission and your ministry to get this audio Bible out there. You have big stars who have agreed to participate in this project, and it's really probably, in your mind, taken on a life of its own.
Yeah, it has, and you know, everyone that's involved in it has been very devoted to it, and are making themselves available even to this day, even though we finished we wrapped it a couple of years ago. People like John Reese Davies and Stacy Keach are still available to help when needed to promote the faith.
Well, that's excellent, and it's something you don't see a lot, is the Hollywood stars participating in sort of what would be considered an evangelization ministry, but it is so important for us as Catholics, for sure, and others, but to be familiar with our Bibles, and this is an easy way and an almost entertaining way for anyone to access an audio Bible.
Yeah, well, a lot of people have said to me, including your Archbishop, who wrote me a wonderful letter, Archbishop Gregory Amon, that by listening to this, that is the way the Bible was first brought to people, you know, because people did not know how to read back in the day, and so it was spoken to them. And people that are engaging in this, listening to it, actually feel like they're, you know, kind of walking in the apostles' footsteps, because you get the sense of the surroundings, and you can really feel it as you listen to it.
Well, and you were telling me, you have a number of endorsements, including Father Robert Barron, and we aired his Catholicism series on WLAE last fall, actually, and Raymond Arroyo, Mother Angelica, bishops from around the country. But to me, as we were talking in preparation for this interview, the comments of the voice of Jesus, and I'll let you tell the story, but the comments from the voice of Jesus from this Bible were very, very touching to me.
Yeah, Neil McDonough, who is our Jesus, he was the lead in Band of Brothers and was in Captain America this past summer. You know, he's an up-and-coming guy. I mean, he's getting a lot of offers nowadays. And he said when he got this role, he thought this was the greatest role he could ever play, even though it's not seen, because he's just a voice. But he was very excited to play it, and had passed on a role a major network had offered him. Because the character that they wanted him to play did not coincide with his Catholic faith, and so he passed. And we wanted whoever was going to play Jesus, obviously, to have strong Catholic ethics, and this gentleman, Neil McDonough, certainly has that.
Well, and that's so important, especially right now in the world today, where Catholics are really fighting for their religious liberty, you know, the idea that... and to live their faith in the public square, and the idea that we have a Hollywood star doing that on his own, that's quite an example for us. Well, I'm looking at your website right now, and actually, it's amazing just watching the clips of the actors as they voice. This was not, you know, sitting in a booth with your headphones on, with your hands over your ears, talking into a microphone. They were very animated as they told the stories.
Yeah, I mean, this is not just something you mail in, so to speak. The people that were involved, our director, Brenda Noel, is a scripture scholar and very meticulous as to how she wanted it expressed. And sometimes something very simple took several takes, but we think we got it right. She certainly did a wonderful job for us, and so did all the actors and actresses. We had over 75 actors and actresses participating on three continents and in 10 studios. So it wasn't all just done in one place. We did some over the phone. Michael York was overseas. John Reese Davies was as well. And okay. We had some people in New York, Chicago, L.A. So we had a number of different places, and these people did a fantastic job, and I think everyone will see that when they listen to it.
Well, good. Well, we are running out of time, but I wanted to make sure that everyone was very clear. You have the audio Bible on CDs that's available, but you also have a free app. Talk to us a little bit about that. And like I said, we are very tight on time.
Okay, well, I'll talk as fast as I can. yeah, we are giving away the complete text of the New Testament along with the audio portion of the Gospel of Mark. Mark is played by Blair Underwood. You go to www.truthandlifeapp.com.
Okay.
And it's all available for you there. And coming soon, we will have the Old Testament as well, text, that will be available. We're working on getting all the proper editing done on that and making sure that we have the proper version, as we do with the New Testament. And once that's correct, we will add it for free for everybody that wants it. And then, of course, you can get the rest of it for a nominal price.
Very good. Well,
or Mike, CD sets.
Right. Yeah, well, Mike, I want to thank you for your for making this your mission and your ministry, and for truly giving us another tool of evangelization to really reach out to those who are thirsting for the word of God. And so, again, for all of our viewers, I want to give you the website. The website for the app is Truth and Light app, truthandlifeapp.com, and the website is www.truthandlifebible.com. Thanks again, Mike, for being with us.
Thank you, Sarah, so much, and God bless you.
Thanks. We'll be right back.
Never forget our best teachers, the ones who do so much more than teach. They inspire and insist we bring our best in everything we do. We find those mentors in our Catholic schools. It's why Catholic school graduates consistently go on to college, land better jobs, embrace faith, and lead. Louisiana Catholic Schools, in a class of their own.
Well, welcome, Tammy Dupree. Thank you very much for being here. Mr. Stephen Scafidi, thanks so much. Such a great story to share today. I want to start off with Tammy. Please tell us what Sojourners is.
Sojourners of the Burning Heart is a prayer group that we started back in 2006. In 2006, through the absolute grace of God and a series of miracles, we ended up taking 32 young people to Medjugorje.
Wow.
And it was miraculous. Yeah. And when we came back, they were all on fire and ready to go forth and share Our Lady's messages with the world. So they said, we have to do something.
Yeah.
We can't just let this lie. So we started the prayer group, Sojourners of the Burning Heart. We meet on Friday nights in my home, anywhere from 20 to 70 young people. We have, pray the rosary, praise and worship. We have speakers come in.
Yeah.
And community. And I think that's the big part, is that they can come together with Catholic community, young people that are of like minds,
yeah.
And share their faith and feel safe.
Yeah.
And feel safe.
Yeah.
So we continue to do this, and we go back every year, take young people, and it's been just amazing what the Lord has done. It's amazing what the Lord has done with this group and what He's done.
Well, one particular way that you can kind of highlight what happened and what goes on was something, the project that y'all worked on together. Is that correct?
Correct.
So, Mr. Scafidi, could you tell us a little bit about this project?
The name of the film is called The Sojourners. I'm a filmmaker. I love making films. I love telling stories. And I was introduced to Tammy and her group and through a friend of mine. And we've always wanted to make a film. I'm always looking for the next great story. When we first met, I didn't want to make a so-called religious film. And I was looking for more of an adventure film. But when I heard that there were 50 young people going to Medjugorje on a pilgrimage, and there were a couple of people on the trip whose parents basically hogtied them and said, you're going. And one of them was my son, who went with me to be my sound man. Mm-hmm. And about 3 days into the shoot, I fired him, and then he really got to experience the trip. It was an incredible journey, and it was the most unlikely film to ever get made. And now I've got seminarians jumping off of cliffs and crazy stuff like that. It's an adventure film. It's a great film that I think will reach out to young people and basically show them that you can be spiritual, you can see God, and you do not have to sit in a monastery to do it.
What's the name of the website?
It's called thesojournersmovie.com.
I went on the website, I clicked onto the trailer, and it was phenomenal. I mean, you really saw, just like what you're saying, guys who just didn't want to be there. Mm-hmm. And then you saw this journey that took place
right.
in this short period of time. And then there's going to be an actual unveiling, is that correct, coming soon?
Yeah, on February the 29th. At doors open at 6 p.m. at Schulte Auditorium at the Notre Dame Seminary, and the Archbishop will be there, and a lot of the who's who in New Orleans
sure.
will be there. It's the world premiere of The Sojourners. Live
yeah.
music from the film starts at 6.
Uh-huh.
Get there early because we can't hold seats for too many people, but
sure.
show starts at 7, and it's going to be a great evening.
Yes.
I mean, so tell me, for you personally, what was this like, going on this journey yourself?
Trust me, I'm at the bottom of the Sojourner ladder. I wasn't even on the ladder when I started. But it, it, it changed my life. It really did. I made a film about 10 years ago called The People's Story when I followed Hurricane Mitch in Honduras. Wow. And it kind of did the same thing in a different way, though. I met people that I thought might have been holy rollers that turned into some of the greatest people I've ever met.
Wow.
I went to prayer. I did the praise and worship when I didn't know what a praise and worship was. I go to church on Sunday. I kind of punch the card and do my thing and then go back to my real world. It's changed me. I see the world in a different way. Tammy's group is phenomenal. They've opened my eyes to a lot of things that I never knew existed. And my son was moved too, in a different way. So I'm looking forward to the 29th. My son will be there, the Sojourners will be there, and we're going to have a great turnout.
Tammy, how has this been for you? I mean, for this kind of fruit to take place, what is it like?
You know, it's amazing. Last night we had a number of the seminarians and young people at the house, and I was just sitting around looking at what the Lord has done in their lives. Some of these kids that were a mess when they went to Medjugorje, you know, that they were really into drugs and doing some things, and now we're going to be moving into discernment houses and, you know, looking at vocations and working for the church. And it just is overwhelming to me what God can do. You know,
God is amazing, and he wants to show up in all of our lives, and praise God to both of y'all to be a conduit and an instrument of that love and of that opportunity to hear the Word of God and the voice of God and to encounter Christ more intimately, more deeply. And we're a people hungry for this burning love.
Yes.
And so I can't thank y'all enough for what you did and for what you continue to do. So God bless you, and thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you so much for having us. We appreciate it. God bless you.
For more information about the Sojourners movie, you can go again to thesojournermovie.com, and we'll be right back.
What will the world ask of them? Whatever it is, they'll be prepared to answer. Because in a safe and disciplined environment, Louisiana Catholic schools shape tomorrow's leaders. Catholic students are rising. 99% graduate. Almost all go to college. They'll earn higher wages, be community involved, more tolerant of diverse views. And the world will be better because of them. Louisiana Catholic Schools, in a class of their own.
And if you have a question for us or have an idea for a story you'd like to see on air, write to us at Issues in Faith, 3330 North Causeway Boulevard, Suite 345, Metairie, Louisiana, 70002, or email us at questions@wlae.com. Plus, if you miss an episode, you can catch up online at www.archdiocese-no.org. And that's our program for this evening. For all of us at Issues in Faith, thanks for watching.
We'll be back next week. Hope you join us again soon. Until then, God bless.